Good morning, happy Saturday. It's Saturday, October 30th, and I recently have been wanting to get back into vlogging. I have taken a bit of a step back from my channel just due to my schedule and burnout and all those fun things, but I think that I'm going to try to film at least once a day and try to cobble together some vlogs for you so that I can keep doing YouTube the way I love to do YouTube. I started off this channel with vlogs and I really miss doing it. So I would love to just film as much as I can, and then when I feel inspired to edit and things like that, I can just put together a vlog for you. So I hope that works for you. It's keeping my skills honed and so that I don't forget how to film things. So in terms of updates, what I'm doing today when it comes to my writing is I started during the worldwide write-a-thon last weekend, I started a series Bible and I found a couple typos in my book. Things that I don't think would really alert anyone. One in particular, yes, it's like literally the wrong version of a word. I wrote your instead of you, and that bummed me out at first. And this book has been out for a month, but I've also realized that these things happen, and what I can do as an independently published author is fix it. I format my own books. So I went into Vellum and I uploaded it. Also, too, I am uploading a new spine for my paperback. I had a logo created by Miblart for my publishing house, and I would like to add that to the book. So while I am re-uploading my book to all the platforms, because I am wide and I also go direct to most of the platforms, I go direct to Amazon, which you should always do. I get the highest royalties. Through Kobo, I publish to Overdrive, I publish direct to Apple Books, Google Play, Barnes & Noble, and I also publish direct myself. Draft to Digital kind of covers all of the rest of the library apps and some distributors that don't allow publishing direct, and then I publish direct for myself on my PayHip on my website. So my PayHip website, I get the most royalties and I get paid right away, which is fantastic when people buy from my website. I will also be running a Black Friday / Cyber Monday deal coming up on my website only when it comes to my books. So stay tuned for that. I will probably post that in my newsletter first, and then maybe some of the social platforms. I've really been trying to stay off social media. It's just too much for me with a day job and authoring and taking care of my family and everything like that. So it works for me. So if you are interested in at all signing up for my newsletter, it comes out bi-weekly. It's in the description box below, and you'll be able to get news more frequently from me about that stuff. So I'm going to go upload to Amazon, and then I'm going to go through as many vendors as I can this morning. I obviously can't do anything with my paperback quite yet. My cover designer is on vacation till Monday, so hopefully they'll get back to me next week, and then I'll be able to upload the paperback to Amazon and Ingram Spark. So it's a bit later, as you can probably tell by my costume change, and I just finished uploading my revised copy of my book to all of the vendors outside of Ingram. As I mentioned, I did want to have my cover designer put the new publishing logo on the spine, so I am going to wait. Ingram usually just takes forever to do everything. I'm fine with the book being out for a couple more days. For that specific version, it's not a big deal. Like I said, the changes are not anything crazy, but in a book that's 65,000 words, going out with one typo is not that bad. So the rest of it's just more preference changes and all of that. That took about 10 minutes to get up on all the vendors. I have a spreadsheet that I track any changes that I make to any of the vendors when it comes to if I have revisions, like typos, things like that. Or as I start to publish my books, my backlist is going to get bigger, and so I want to go in every time with these books and update the backlist in the back of the book so that it stays up to date. So that is my way of tracking. I do that in Excel. I got that idea from a friend of mine and it's been so helpful and it really helps me focus. And also too, if I get mom brain and I like forget, or oh shoot, did I do that? I can go back and look and make sure I did do it. Also, today is the AuthorTube NaNoWriMo Survival Swap Extravaganza. I took part in it. It's hosted by Kevin the writer, and I've been watching those videos throughout the day. I have a visitor at my house today, so I have been trying to spend time with them and not be on YouTube, but I did take a quick break to quickly do this. And if you're at all interested in watching those videos, I'll link the playlist down below. It's a lot of fun and I loved watching who I swapped with. I loved watching their video. So yeah, that's all I'm probably gonna do with my author stuff for today. I do have a million things I could be doing, but I try not to do too many things on the weekends, usually one or two tasks that I haven't been able to do throughout the week. So yeah, I will check in with you soon. It is November 4th. It's Thursday. It's a very special day. But first of all, I wanted to address the cat in the room. Yes, we got a cat. As you saw, that's Gizzie. That's our nickname for her. She is a rescue. She is 14 years old. As my dog has gotten older, I've had a renewed appreciation for senior animals. So we're happy to have her join our family. She's so sweet, very vocal. She is very generous with her purrs and we absolutely love her. We had a bit of a trial with her, which is why I didn't make any announcements or really tell many people, because I wanted to make sure. My husband is very allergic to animals, which is why our dog is hypoallergenic, and surprisingly he's not allergic to the cat. That was number one. We wanted to make sure she got along with Kiddo, which she does, and she doesn't quite get along with the dog. It's not like some bad scenario. She just runs away. I think she's a little bit fearful, but she's warming up a little bit. So we've had her for about 2 weeks now, and I've heard with cats it can take a while for them to get like fully acclimated to a new place, so we're extremely happy to have her. And she's such a dear and she's so cute. Also today I am starting, even though it's 6 o'clock in the morning, I'm starting to get very nervous. At 11 I have a long-awaited interview with Joanna Penn. I'm so excited that she allowed me to be on her podcast. It's not gonna go live for another couple months, but I'm so excited and so nervous. She's like an idol of mine. I listen to mostly all of her episodes when they come out. I'm so thrilled that she accepted when I asked to be on her podcast to talk about Take Back Your Book and rights reversion and all that. I listened to enough of her episodes and I did an episode search on her website to make sure that she hadn't discussed it before, because she has well over 500 episodes. So I'm very nervous and I'm very excited. Mostly nervous, but excited, because she's just fantastic. Yesterday I did get back my spine for Soul Taken with my new publishing logo on it, and it looks phenomenal. I went on to Amazon and Ingram Spark and uploaded the revision, and I am waiting to hear back from Ingram Spark because they usually take a couple days to like review it, and then I want to order a proof copy from them, an author copy since the book is out, and also Amazon, and I want to just see it and make sure it prints out okay. And yeah, I'm really excited for that. I will show you when I get those what they look like, because from the picture it looks fantastic. And also I go on a writing retreat today, this weekend. I'm so excited to go back to the Highlights Foundation. I had planned to go back in 2020, things happened, and I finally got there. I'm getting there. So last night was filled with packing, and it's November, so it's very cold. So my suitcase is bursting with sweatshirts and sweatpants because I fully intend to embrace the writer life while I'm there. I have to pack a few more things that I just tend to use like on the day-to-day, like my toiletries and my computer stuff and this camera. So I have a nice handy-dandy list of things that I need to pack, and I already have 3 bags, so We'll see how that goes. I may have to take some things out because it's only 4 days, but I'm so excited to go with Katie, who you saw that I went with last time in my highlights vlog. I will also link that in the description if you're interested in watching my previous one. And I'm going with Julie and Amber, who are the other two co-hosts of the Writer's Hive. And I'm just so excited to see all of them in person. It's been so long. I've only actually met Julie and Amber once in person, but I've been friends with them for a while now. So I'm really excited, and I am going to post that video next week. So I'm gonna wrap it up here. And if you enjoyed this vlog, be sure to give it a big thumbs up because it really helps me out. Hit that subscribe button and the little notification bell next to it the next time I upload, and so you don't miss that vlog. And I'll see you soon.